What's up? This is Matt Brown coming at you with another IoT hacking video. Today we are going to be dumping firmware using U-Boot on an embedded Linux system over UART that we have found on the board and soldered onto, and we're using a UART USB adapter to connect that to our computer. I first want to ask everyone to subscribe to my YouTube channel, comment on the videos, tell me what you like, tell me what you don't like. I'd like to thank everyone who has subscribed and has been commenting on my videos. It really helps me to know what kind of content you want me to do next. So without further ado, we're going to go over the desk and check out the device we are looking at today. So this is the same DSL router. You may recognize it from one of my other videos that we looked at, and we soldered on to UART, the UART connector right here on the board. We've got our TX, RX, and ground lines. I'm going to leave a link in the description of this video to that other video of mine if you're curious how we set this up, but just wanted to look back here to show there's nothing crazy going on. This is the device we will be connecting to today over UART and connecting to specifically the bootloader of this system. So I have this turned on right now. I'm actually going to turn this device off, and then we are going to navigate over to the terminal, and we're going to connect first to UART. So we're going to use our trusty PicoCom tool. This is going to allow us to interact with the console over UART. And then we're going to set the baud rate, which again I described in the previous video that we discovered was this baud rate that I have typed in. And then dev tty USB 0 is the USB serial device that I have connected to my computer. So when I go ahead and hit enter, it's going to be connected. And since the device is not powered on, I don't see anything. So I'm going to power on this device without interacting with it first, just to see what the normal boot flow looks like. So here we see you print out some stuff, and then we're going to see a bunch of things scroll by on this screen. But I'm going to scroll up before all that data scrolls by, and we're going to look at the first things that we see printed out on the system. So the first thing that comes out when we start the system up is this U-Boot output here. So it says U-Boot 1.1.4 for some chipset by this person, and then all this other fun information. So this is telling us that the bootloader of this system is U-Boot, and then you'll see an interesting message here that says hit any key to stop auto boot. So by default, this is going to wait, you know, a second, a fraction of a second, and if no keyboard input happens, like on this boot process here that we just initiated, it will go ahead and boot the Linux kernel, which will load the full system and give us this shell environment that we talked about in the last video. But if we want to get into the bootloader, what we're going to do is I'm going to turn the device off. I'm not going to flip the camera back over. You can trust me. And then I'm going to hold down my enter key, and I'm going to turn the device back on. And now we have paused the boot process, and we can type H, and we get a nice little help menu. So now what we're going to do is we're going to use some of these tools here that U-Boot gives us access to in the bootloader. This is an unprotected bootloader on this system, and we're going to use this in this video to extract the firmware over UART. So you'll notice there's a bunch of different utilities here. We're going to use a couple of these utilities to get the info we need. So the primary tool that we're going to be using is this memory display command. So this is going to allow us to get a hex dump of some specific segment of memory that we specify to it. The documentation in this tool is terrible. You have to actually go online to learn the full scope of what you can do with some of these tools. And then the other, but the first tool we're going to look at today is this BD info. So this is going to tell us some key piece of information. So this flash start and flash size variable are what we're looking for right now. So flash start, that's where the flash chip is mapped into memory. So when we want to do a memory display, we want to start displaying memory at this address. And then the second question, so if we know where our start address is, then the second question we have to ask is how much data to read after that start address. And that's where this flash size variable comes into play. So we see this given to us in hex, a hex value for the size of the flash chip. So what we're going to do is we're going to open up Python over here in another terminal, and we're going to do some quick math. So I'm going to copy this, and so we can see that gives us some integer. But this memory display command, as I will show here, so let's say I want to, you know, read from this address, and let's just put in a 1 here and see what it does. So we see that this number field in this MD command actually specifies the amount of words to read out. So in embedded systems, a word size is just, so if it's a 32-bit system, then it's 32 bits or 4 bytes for a word. And so we can see that if we specify 1, we actually get 4 bytes. So if we want to print, if we want to dump this many bytes, we're going to just take our number over here and divide it by 4, and then we're going to just save this value for later. So now we actually know the full command we want to run. We want to run the command md this, and then that. But before I run that command, I'm going to actually exit out of PicoCom. I'm going to hit Control A, Control X, and we're going to set up PicoCom to log all of the input and output over this UART connection to a file. So I'm going to close out that math we were doing there. And the way we do that is with an option in PicoCom. And if I can find it here in our help page, I can. So this dash dash log file command. So we are going to just pull up our same PicoCom command, but we're going to go dash dash log file. And then I'm going to just call this output.txt. And then going to hit enter. So now all of the input and output that is going on over the serial connection is going to be logged into that file. So I actually already had that command typed in the UART terminal. So I can just hit enter. And now that command gets run, and it is going to dump all of the firmware contents in this hex dump format. And this is going to go on for hours. It is going to take hours and hours for this process to complete. So if you're doing this, you're trying to dump firmware, I suggest doing it overnight. I am going to exit out of this right now because I already have a file set up, so I'm just going to get rid of that. I already did this last night, so I did this firmware extraction process, and much like your favorite cooking show, we've got this already out of the oven. Here we go. We've dumped all our firmware. And we can see here that we get a bunch of junk because this really is truly logging all of the input and the output that we gave here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to clean up this file. So here we see our command that we entered and the output of that process. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to clean up this file. So I'm going to get rid of that stuff at the start. I just want this hex output. And then at the end, I really don't know why it prints this right at the end, but we're going to get rid of that. And we're going to save that file just like that. And then what we need to do is we need to convert this hex dump format. Like, I don't care about this address. I don't care about this ASCII representation at the end. What I really care about is this, the actual raw data that we just dumped from the flash on this device. So what I have written is this firmware tools repository, I have a little script called parse uboot dump, and I actually will post this up on in the description of the video, and it will also be here on my GitHub page. So you can see it's just a really simple Python script that goes through and converts that hexadecimal ASCII data into binary data, and then outputs it into a file that we specify in a file name parameter. So back over here, we're going to use this tool, and we are going to run Python 3 firmware tools. Going to run our script. So it takes two parameters. First is the input file, and then the output file name. So we'll just call the output file name firmware.bin. Call it whatever you want. And now we have a file here, and we can use our trusty XXD to just kind of look at that. And there we go. So now this is actually just dumped the binary data into a file that we can now use binwalk, your trusty binwalk, or other firmware analysis tools to go ahead and analyze your firmware and do any extractions that you would want to do on this firmware. So, thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, if you have any other types of firmware extraction videos that you would like me to do, please comment in this video, and have a great day.